From cute and furry to huge and ferocious, God has painted a beautiful world filled with an amazing variety of mammals. Today, there are over 5,000 types of mammals in existence. All mammals are animals, but not all animals are mammals. The animal kingdom is divided into many different classes, such as birds, fish, and reptiles, each class sharing similar characteristics. Mammals are just one of the classes of the animal kingdom. In order to be classified as a mammal, certain traits must be present, though some of these traits are not limited to only mammals. For example, like birds, mammals are endotherms, meaning they are warm-blooded. They can generate and regulate their own body heat because they have a very fast metabolism, which also means they need to eat a lot and often. Mammals eat more than the cold-blooded reptiles of the same size, and the food they eat gets converted into energy, which is like fuel to keep their body temperatures regulated. This fast metabolism requires a high amount of oxygen, so mammals' respiratory and circulatory systems must be efficient. With specially designed lungs that are filled with grape-shaped air sacs called alveoli, mammals are well equipped to collect more oxygen. The air sac's shape provides more surface area, allowing plenty of oxygen to pass through to the surrounding blood vessels. A four-chambered heart helps pump the oxygen-rich blood through the mammal's body. As part of the chordata phylum of vertebrates, mammals have a spinal column, also known as a backbone. Having a backbone gives the mammal structure. Notice this worm doesn't have a backbone. But with vertebrates, backbones allow for standing up straight and walking or other movement. Can you think of other animals that are not mammals that also have backbones? Birds, fish, and reptiles are examples of other animals that are also vertebrates. From this, we can conclude that having a backbone, amongst other features, can't be reserved to just mammals. Here are characteristics found just in mammals. Most mammals do not lay eggs and wait for them to hatch, and all mammals develop from eggs within their mother. Mammalian babies that come from eggs that aren't laid will be carried within the mother until the baby has grown enough and is prepared to be born. Even after they are born, newborn mammals rely on their mothers for nutrition, shelter, protection, and care for a period of time. The word mammal comes from the Latin word mamma, meaning breast. Many mammals have mammary glands, and some of these glands are located on the breast, while other mammals have them on other parts of their bodies. For example, a cat has two rows of mammary glands on their underbellies. Mammary glands produce milk which feed the mother's new young. Interestingly, only the mammalia class can do this. The mother nurses or feeds her young until they are developed enough to eat solid food. During this time of nursing, the baby receives plenty of nourishment from its mother, as well as learning through example and interaction of how to function as a new animal. All mammals have three bones in the middle ear. This special design allows mammals to have sharper hearing, and sound waves go through more easily. Each bone is linked to the previous bone like a chain, so these sound waves, which form vibrations in the mammalian ear, can be clearly transmitted. Many groups of animals have teeth, so teeth are not unique to only mammals. For example, some fish and reptiles have teeth. However, most mammals typically have two sets of teeth. Baby teeth present themselves first, and later permanent teeth come in. Permanent teeth can replace baby teeth or just come in on their own. This means that some teeth in some mammals do not fall out, and some teeth come in later without a first set of baby teeth to replace. Each species of mammal has a specific tooth structure and makeup based on their diet and the way they eat their food. All mammals have hair growing from some part of their body, at least during some point in their lives. Some mammals have large amounts of thick fur or hair, while others have very little. If you were to examine a big whale swimming in the ocean, which is a mammal, you might not find any hair, but whales do have a small amount of hair during their earliest stage of development. Wouldn't it look a little funny if we, as human mammals, grew as much hair as a bear? Thankfully, how much hair or fur a mammal has, and where it grows, depends on the type of mammal. While other vertebrates have jaws made from multiple bones, mammals uniquely have a lower jawbone that is one single piece directly connected to the jaw. The two muscles that move a mammal's jaw allows the jaw to move up and down or side to side. This feature gives mammals the distinguishing ability to purposefully chew our food. Only mammalian brains have a neocortex, which is found in a section of the brain called the cerebral cortex. The neocortex is what gives mammals higher functioning abilities, like to perceive and become aware of things through their senses. The ability to reason when approaching a problem and to have conscious thought are also special abilities of the neocortex. For us as humans, communicating is performed in the neocortex as well. Also, in the human brain, the neocortex is quite large, which is why we are more advanced and have the ability to do and think much more than other species. Get ready to explore the amazing world of mammals in this science unit, as we recognize God's creativity and majesty in designing such unique, amazing, funny, intelligent, sweet, useful, beautiful, and even peculiar creatures.